And so this call narrative speaks about, to me personally, a place of holiness, because God tells Moses to take off his shoes.
Yes.
Because the place you're coming towards is holy ground. And as in the text, God invites and calls us to a relationship that is profoundly different from any relationship we have ever experienced.
Yes. Yes.
Moses is here with his life. He sees this bush burning, but it's not being consumed.
Yes.
It's different.
Yeah.
It's a wall, it's something different, something that's got his attention. And we find ourselves in places where finally God has our attention. But he's in a place where God is about to call Moses to a place of purposefulness. But it's a different experience. He had never had this relationship or this type of relationship before. Well, he had to take off his shoes before he gets into this person's presence. And as in this text, Moses never experienced a bush that appears to be on fire, but not consumed. But God speaks and invites him to a purpose from God. Rather than being consumed by God, God calls him to a purpose for God. Stay with me. We may find ourselves so many times that we have been in a place that this is it. God is continuing to bring us over and over and through and over and through and over and through. God has not allowed our circumstances to consume us. But God has allowed us to receive grace. And I always say that grace will always find you. And so during those times, God wants to get our attention. Because this text helps us to understand, to bear witness that God is an awesome creator.
Yes.
Who does not give up on his own creation, the one who does not leave us in our mess.
Yes.
You see, the people, they were in Egypt.
Yes.
Not speaking anything bad about Egypt, but it was a place of bondage. A place of frustration,
yeah.
A place of lack.
Yeah.
There was no abundance, there was no hope. They were in bondage, and the Bible says that God heard and saw the suffering of his people.
Yes.
Now God could have called the angels down, God could have called the cherubims and the seraphims down, but God did not call the angels down. He called a man that was in the desert who felt like nothing to deliver his people.
Yes.
And give him a purpose. And so Moses, as we learn that God suffers with us, and God suffers with us in our reluctance, in our stubbornness, in our rebellion, God still sticks with us. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Because despite that God wanted to call Moses to a purpose, Moses was still reluctant about who this God is and calling me to a purpose. You know how we do. God, I need to see your driver's license. I need to see your passport. I'm not quite sure. I don't know. I can't talk. I'm too old. I'm too fat. I'm not a pastor. I can't articulate. I owe a lot of money. I make a lot of mistakes. I'm a failure. I'm this, I'm that. But God stood there and suffered with him despite his reluctance. And this is a narrative, despite Moses' reluctance and the people's stubbornness, God still suffered long with them. God still walked them through and many days and many nights and many years. God provided over and over and over and over kept doubting God. They didn't have Red Cross or Blue Cross. They didn't have SSI, SSD. They didn't have the finances on the third of the month or the first of the month. They didn't have to cash their checks. They didn't have money. They didn't have a bus. They didn't have transportation. All they had was God in the desert.
Yes.
And still, they became reluctant and they became stubborn. But God stuck with them. We know the end of the story that even though their reluctance had run out, God allowed them to die in the desert. But he did not give up on the people. Because they, the ones of the next generation went and took over. Overall, this narrative speaks to me of God's purposefulness and sovereignty in relation to this world. This purposefulness and sovereignty has shaped and can shape our experience that God is Emmanuel, whose presence is always with us. Jesus came to this world as Emmanuel, and his last words before he ascended into heaven were, "I am with you always, yes, to the end of the age."
Yes.
So therefore, despite the challenge that may come in our cup, despite the challenge that may come in our ministry, despite the challenge that may come in our life, despite the challenge that may come in our marriage, despite the challenge that comes in our finances, in our bodies, in our relationship, in our children, despite the challenges, we can easily say and boldly say, we are able to persevere in confidence because God is there with us. And so Moses, his life feeling alienated and being reluctant to be used by God, God is calling him to a purpose. And I want you to reflect on the times and even today of what you might be going through. Even if it's finding yourself going around in circles, you find yourself in a place of a vacuum and something is void and something is empty and things are getting frustrated. And it's a way that God helps to get our attention to look to the side and see that the bush is not burning and why it's not burning. And I want to invite you today, tomorrow, in the days that God has given you breath, that when you find yourself at the end of your rope, when you find yourself at the end of that wall, when you find yourself, you went on and done all you can do, take your shoes off.
Yes.
And know that you are stepping in to holy ground.
Yes.
God is calling you to a purpose.
Yes.
God is calling you to a place of usefulness. A place of sovereignty to help somebody. I don't know who it is. But nothing happens outside the will of God. And so when you find yourself in that place, be open and humble enough not to wrestle with God, but to take your shoes off and get down and say, "Lord, here I am. What will you have me to do? My eyes are yours. My hands are yours. My mind is yours. My body is yours. Take me and use me, God. And let God turn your midnight around. And then turn your joy into dancing." Because we know that weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. In closing, the Bible tells us in Psalms, "Don't be like a horse that has to have a bit put in his mouth so you can be turned where you need to go. But gain understanding in all your pity. Get wisdom and fear the Lord. God has called you to a place that he would never, never leave you or forsake you. I don't know how long I will be with you, but I know who sits high and I know who looks low. As we reflect, I ask Kate, come on, Kate, bring your selection.